Funky Friday Anatomy Quiz, and it's picture quiz time. 5 pictures with questions on each structure. Remember, you can stop the video if you need a little bit of extra time. So if you're ready, grab a pen and let's get to it. Question 1. What is the name of this muscle? What are its insertions? What does it do? And what is the nerve supply of this muscle? Question 2. What is this structure called? Which hormones does it produce? And what do they do? Question 3. What is the name of this structure? And what are the labelled parts A to D called? And if we turn it, you can see that there are 3 openings. So which structures go through these openings and at which vertebral levels? And finally, what is the nerve supply to this structure? Question 4, what is the name of this structure? What are its proximal and distal relations? Which structures lie anteriorly to it? And what is its blood supply? We started with a muscle, so we will end with a muscle. What is the name of this muscle? What are its bony attachments? Which 2 other muscles insert with it? And what is this insertion called? And what is the nerve supply of this muscle? So the answers. Question 1 was the brachialis muscle, which lies in the anterior compartment of the arm. It attaches to the anterior aspect of the distal humerus, and it inserts onto the ulnar tuberosity and the coronoid process of the ulna. It therefore forms the floor of the triangular-shaped cubital fossa, which is found in the anterior aspect of the elbow joint. It is a powerful flexor of the elbow, and it is supplied by the nerve of the anterior compartment of the arm, which is the musculocutaneous nerve. Question 2. This was the thymus gland, which is found in the superior mediastinum, and it can extend into the anterior mediastinum. It is a lymphoid organ and is very active in childhood. White blood cells, also known as lymphocytes or immature T cells, that are made in the bone marrow, travel via the bloodstream to the thymus. The thymus gland produces the hormones thymopoietin and thymulin, which cause the maturation and differentiation of these immature lymphocytes into specialized T cells, which once fully formed, get sprinkled around the body in lymph glands, where they wait on guard for the first signs of attack from an enemy pathogen. The thymus also produces the hormones thymusin and the thymic humoral factor. Now these hormones increase the immune response to fight pathogens. The answer to question 3 was the diaphragm, which is a double-domed musculotendinous sheet. And at rest, you can see that the right side is slightly higher than the left due to the presence of the liver pushing upwards from the abdomen. The labelled area A is the right crust, B is a left crust, C is a muscular portion of the diaphragm, and D is the central tendon. The 3 openings that you can see in the diaphragm are firstly the caval hiatus, which is at the level of T8, and this transmits the inferior vena cava and the terminal branches of the right phrenic nerve. The esophageal hiatus, which is at the level of T10, transmits the esophagus, the right and left vagus nerves, and the esophageal branches of the left gastric artery and left gastric vein. The final opening is the aortic hiatus at the level of T12. Now this transmits the aorta, the thoracic duct, the zygous vein. The diaphragm is supplied by the phrenic nerve, which comes from the roots C3 to C5. The mnemonic that I use is C345 keeps the diaphragm alive. The structure in question 4 is the sigmoid colon, which is continuous with the descending colon proximally and the rectum distally. It is approximately 40 centimeters long and has a characteristic S shape to it. It commences around the level of the pelvic brim and it descends into the pelvis, where it lies behind the bladder and also behind the uterus in women. The blood supply to the colon is from sigmoidal branches that come directly from the inferior mesenteric artery, which in turn comes directly from the abdominal aorta at the level of about L3. The answer to question 5 was the sartorius muscle, which arises from the anterior superior iliac spine, from the hip bone, and it is a long, slender and graceful muscle that runs obliquely across the front of the thigh to insert onto the upper part of the medial aspect of the tibia. It inserts along with gracilis and semitendinosus, and the insertion of this group of three tendons is known as the pes anserinus, as it resembles a goose's foot. And the mnemonic for this is say grace before tea. The name sartorius is derived from the Latin sartor, which means tailor, and it refers to how tailors used to sit cross-legged on the floor. The sartorius is supplied by the femoral nerve, which is the nerve for the anterior compartment of the thigh. So how did you do this week? If you liked our quiz, give us a thumbs up, hit subscribe, tell all your friends, and remember, it's Friday! So stay funky!